Okay. Welcome, everybody. Thank you for being here tonight. Very exciting time for us. I'm very pleased to welcome you at Exnode tonight. Thank you all. So, a few words before we get started. Explain what is Le Wagon about, maybe for the 1% of you who wouldn't know what's going on here. Le Wagon is a coding school. We founded this school in Paris in 2013. And now we are operating in 19 different countries worldwide. We are in Lisbon, we are in Barcelona, we are in Amsterdam, in Berlin, in Sao Paulo, in Montreal, in Tokyo, and we are in China. We've been running the operations here for about 6 months. Tonight, we introduce you our first batch. Maybe it's a very exciting time for us, obviously. And the next sessions will be in May and again in July, in Shanghai, and also in Chengdu, in the Sichuan province. So what is this coding school about? Our mission is to bring technical skills to creative people and to entrepreneurs. So they have ideas. They have business ideas. And they want to transform it into technical solutions. They want to build a product, but they lack the skills. So we help them to learn to code. We teach them programming languages, HTML and CSS and JavaScript and Ruby and so on and so on. And then they can create beautiful products. So it's not only about learning to code. We also teach them the mindset, the soft skills, so that they can have an idea and turn it into a solution. They can work as a team. And collaboration, teamwork on a software is really hard. So what you're going to notice tonight is an amazing work for the past 9 weeks. We have this program that we call a bootcamp. A bootcamp means that it is very intense, very short, very, very tough. And we push them into this environment to make what you will see tonight, a product, their own first prototype. I'm going to show you the amazing humans that went through this journey with us. Here they are, and they will do the show tonight. You can applaud them already. They are right here and are getting nervous right now. Thank you all. So what did they do over this past 2 months? A couple of pictures, cheesy pictures. It started with drinks, of course, it always starts with drinks, meetups, right? And then it went to coding, live coding, learning to code with mentors. They had more drinks together, then they started to visit companies, and then they did more code together, they did some sport together, they did some teamwork, live coding, and party, of course, party, drinks, and then they worked with mentors. And then they worked as a team for the past 2 weeks to make this achievement. So I don't know how many programmers are here in this room, but you will see that what they have achieved in 2 weeks is incredible. They worked very hard. I don't know so many programmers able or having the courage in us to do as much work in 2 weeks' time. Moving on, we're getting down to the business, I promise. Here are the partners. We're here at Exnode. We're very happy to be here. They made this experience very smooth for all of us. That's where the bootcamp is happening. We are obviously working a lot with the French tech, helping us in our mission, all these entrepreneurs. We are a French company. We are working with Gizit Technology to help us to make this video broadcast tonight. We have all these companies from Techstar to DV to Modules to help us in this mission. So thank you, all these partners, for making it happen. Now, finally, I have three panelists here with us tonight. Before we start this show, I will ask each of them to introduce yourself a little bit to the audience. Tang first.
Thank you. Hello, I'm Tang. I'm one of the co-founders of Strikingly, which is a tool that lets you build your own website super easily. We are based here, and I'm thrilled to be here.
Thank you. I think most of the guys actually would know me. I'm Wenwei, founder of Exnode. Welcome to Exnode.
Hi, I'm Donan. I'm part of a startup called iHeHuo. We help entrepreneurs find their co-founders by discovering connections between people and then seeing how they might be similar or how they might complement each other to form better relationships. I also had the privilege of being able to help out with the camp. And seeing how these guys come along from 9 weeks ago, it's kind of inspiring, actually. I hope I can always learn as much as these guys have in the past 9 weeks. And I'm very happy to be here as well. Thank you.
Thank you so much. So we are now getting started. Here are the rules. It's very, very simple. Each team will have 10 minutes to introduce their demo. Okay, they will explain everything they have achieved in the last 2 weeks. And then we have 5 minutes of questions and answers here with the panel so that we can get to know more about the product and their vision. Okay, 3 teams. And then obviously we have more drinks and more social time. Thank you all for being here. Let's get started with the first group. The first group will be IB. I'm asking now Patricia from Germany, Max from Kyrgyzstan, Antoine from France to join me here. First group, IB. It's not about honey. It's a platform, you will see, it's very well executed. Beautiful idea.
Thank you very much. Okay, while Max is setting up, I'm already starting. My name is Patricia, and I welcome you very, very much to join us tonight for our final presentation. We are super excited to present to you what we did in the last 2 weeks. It was hard. We had a lot of discussions. We had a lot of fun, but it was really tough. First, I would like to introduce to you the team I've been working with for the past 2 weeks. First, we have Antoine from France. He came to China already 13 years ago. He's successfully running his own business, and 9 weeks ago, he started to learn coding. Second, we have Max from Kyrgyzstan. Max is one of the brains in our batch, and I'm very, very proud that I had the possibility to work with him together. Last but not least, we had one other team member, Thomas, hi Thomas. He can't be here today because he already had to go back to Tokyo to start his job there. Now, I would like to introduce you to our product. We developed a platform called IB. I from the Chinese word Aihao, hobby. B from the last part of hobby. So, what is it about? It's about sharing your passion and exploring new and interesting events. Why should something like that be interesting for us? Well, let me give you a couple of reasons. First, especially for local people here, it sometimes is hard to come up with new ideas or to find something cool to do during the weekend. Where would you look for something like that? Well, there are platforms. There are actually a lot of platforms, but many of them are like for networking. This is not something you want to do over the weekend. Second, if you have a unique knowledge, a skill, or something you're super passionate about, why shouldn't you share it? Why shouldn't you be making your own events and try to inspire other people? Try to get other people to join you. And third, we are living in a time where it's not so much about how much money you make, or where you travel, or what you shop. The real currency today is a social currency, is with whom you spend the time, doing what, learning what, improving yourself. This is why we created IB. Now let me guide you through our platform. There are actually 2 use cases. The first one is, if you are somebody who's looking for something interesting, inspiring to do over the weekend, you get to our homepage. You see a list of recommended hobbies. You see different categories. You see the top hosts. And then, if you are interested in something, first, you could check out the person who provides this. Is this person really, really good? Just click on his profile or her profile. And then you will be able to see a lot of like personal details that you can write and also update over the time. Oh, sorry, I forgot this functionality. You of course can sign in. So after browsing, you will be asked to sign in to see more details. And then you can read about that person. You can contact that person. Afterwards, you see, might think, okay, Nora, that person really seems to know something about Shibori. But now I want to ask you, what kind of event would you like to attend? What kind of hobby you would like to explore? Okay, teach your cat to fly. Very good choice. So when you get to the hobby detail page, you will see a like possibility. So actually, we already liked it. Everybody can like, but reviews are only going to appear if somebody already attended the event. Unfortunately, we cannot attend this event because it's our own. So let's go back and choose one that we can attend. And so we don't lose too much time on this. I will just say, let's try the Shibori one. It's up because it has quite high rating because we booked it a lot. Our test was this event. So, and then we will see the summary, the description. What are we going to do during one event? Where are we going to meet? And of course, then we have the ability to book. I'm not sure. Which one would you like to book, Max? Let's take next week. Okay. Because next week I'm not attending. Oh, I already made a booking for that. Okay. After I have a booking for this, I will be guided to the dashboard. And then I will be asked on future events, I will see what I booked, and there I can also pay my event. I will, when I click on pay, I will get a QR code, and that is like the WeChat QR code where you can receive money. So afterwards, I will attend this event, I will join this experience, and when this is over, I will be able, I can see the details, sorry. In the details, that is one very cool feature, I think that also makes us a bit special. We can see who else is going. Oh, I rejected two? Okay. Pending means those people don't have paid yet. This will be introduced in a while. But here, if I would be interested in, for example, Max, and I would like to check on, like, who is Max, I could also, of course, go to his profile. So, after an event, I will get a notification that I should rate this event and review it. I can give comments for it, and I can give a star review. The comments will appear on the home, the detail page of a hobby so that other people who want to attend can see how somebody felt having this experience. Now I would like to introduce you to the second use case. This is the one of somebody who has a passion, who has a knowledge about a unique skill. If we, for example, get to this page and then we see, I also know somebody, something I would like to share. I can just easily create a hobby. Afterwards, of course, I will be able to edit it, to adapt it more to the market, to see if, after getting a first feeling, what I have to improve. So if somebody booked, after this hobby, I have to create an event actually for this. In my host dashboard, I will see all my hobbies, and I will be able to create events for each and single hobby I have. Do you want to create one? Okay, let's take the Russian babushka life session. So for this, you can just add a hobby, and afterwards, this will be published, and the guests in this page are going to see the different events, they could join and pay for. Back in my guest, in my host home dashboard, I will be able to manage all the existing and incoming requests. If somebody booked my event, I will be notified. I will have the ability to accept it after receiving the money or to reject this booking. I will be able to update events and to adapt them to my needs. So after this, after people attend an event, I will also receive all the comments and the reviews. And with this, I finished both user cases that I have, and I would like to wrap up why I think, or why we think, IB is a great opportunity. IB does not only help you to share your passion, but IB also helps to create a community of people who inspire and who want to be inspired, of people who want to improve their life, who want to have a cool free time, of people who want to make new friends. Thank you very much. Now I would like to ask Max and Antoine to join me, and we are super happy and curious about the questions that you might have or you would like to ask us. Anybody?
What are your hobbies? Like your three, like if you were to share a passion, what would it be? If you were to post something on this platform? Like is that what you were inspired by? Like your personal hobbies? Your personal passions?
Not 100%.
Okay.
It was more that I had the other way around.
Okay, okay.
That I was creating events and I was helping other people to share their hobbies, uh-huh. But we didn't have like a real platform where we would do it. And like some platforms are quite nice to use but very complicated, and we wanted to have something where you can have like this quality control mechanism also of judging and reviewing things, of directly communicating with the host, and okay. Also seeing the other people who join you.
Well, if you ask me what kind of hobby I would post on this platform, it would probably be like jamming guitar in the park. Uh-huh. Right? And like I think everyone had this situation when you it's a weekend and you don't really know what to do and you start searching on internet and there are so many different websites, but it's all like widespread. So we hope that with this platform, you can combine all that different ideas that you can do with your free time. It's not necessarily networking, it's just having fun, having cool time together, right?
And me, just 3 months ago, I tried because I live in French Alps, and my passion, my hobby is skiing. So I wanted to make a group in Shanghai of people passionate by ski off track. So free riding. So actually, I sent some invitation of many, many social network, many WeChat group. And because because I wanted to find for Japan, for such very narrow period in Chinese New Year, some people doing free ride, and honestly, it was almost mission impossible. And this platform didn't exist at the time, and I think it totally filled my need at the time.
Yes.
So I think it's a great idea for that.
Any other questions? Yeah, please. Yeah, okay, the payment system. Of course, without initial financing is a bit hard. So we were thinking about, for the beginning, we won't be charging anybody posting an event or a hobby, but afterwards we want to develop a subscription model that after a certain amount of events created or people attended one specific hobby, that you would be charged like a commission fee. That was our first thought. Like within the last 2 weeks, we didn't think too much like how we would make more money out of that. But that was like the first things we brainstormed. Another question?
Last question?
Yeah, no, sure.
No, go for it.
No. Donan, can I take the lady first?
Of course.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
It was not easy, to be honest. We had a lot of struggles, especially in the first week, because we just know each other since 7 weeks, and we have very different strengths, very different characters. But after the first bumpy days, especially this week, was amazing. I really, really loved it. And yesterday, we stayed so long, and Antoine was turning off the lights afterwards, and we were thinking, oh, and now this is over. So actually, we didn't have a super clear project role division structure because we don't have a designer or anybody in our team. We have some people like Max who are better than others in the back end, but of course, we also wanted to do some back end. So it was not the very professional way of structuring the project, but the way that worked for us and the way that we got our product up and running.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Big applause for the first group.
Well done, IB. Amazing one.
Okay, now I would like to welcome the second group for tonight. Here is Total Camp. So I have John, Alan, and Jason from the US. We have Stefan from Switzerland right here. Here we go. Total Camp, second group. Big round of applause for them, please.
All right. Oh, you want to get us hooked up? All right. So, it's been a very, very challenging 9 weeks. They've gone by very quickly. But we've had a lot of great support from our teachers, our mentors, and I think we've done, like all the other groups, more in 9 weeks than we ever thought possible. So we're going to show you a turtle camp once we get set up. But basically, you know, in 2 months ago, a little over 2 months ago, none of us had any coding experience. And our team attempted to develop a software as a service. So if you're a developer, you know how much work that takes. And we going from newbies to basically trying to make a product that we could get to market to use in just 2 weeks was very, very difficult. So we hope you like what we've done so far. And
Can I ask a question right now?
Yeah, go for it.
So what was your what was your inspiration behind this idea?
I've been involved in the education industry for about 7 years. And if you don't know, the education industry in China is quite big. Parents and students are under a lot of pressure to get into top universities. And there's about 500,000 students, Chinese students, studying abroad in the United States, in the UK, in Australia. So parents invest a lot of money into getting their students into the top schools. And so through my experience of trying as a college counselor, as somebody who's helping these students get into these top schools, the management process gets quite messy. So is anybody here involved in the education industry in China? A few people? Oh, okay. All right, a few people. So if you don't know, as you might probably know, parents put a lot of pressure on their students to get into top schools. They invest a lot of money. They hire people like me, a college counselor, to help their students manage the process. But when you're going through this process, each student is applying to about 10 to 15 universities. Each one of these universities has their own deadlines. They have their own application items. You need to get letters of recommendation. You need to get transcripts. Basically, it's a mess. You have documents, and as you probably know, it looks like there's a lot of expats here. Your usual documents management systems like Google Drive, they don't work in China. And they especially aren't compatible with the ways that Chinese students might be working, which, surprise, isn't through email. And if they are using email, things like QQ and 163, they don't work well in the way that you're used to in terms of managing documents. So we created a solution to manage the messy application process, and it's called Turtle Camp. Turtle Camp, the name comes from sea turtle. In Chinese, that's called Hai Gui. So these are the names of students who leave China's shores, go abroad to get their education, and then come back. So that's where we got the name turtle from. And really what we're trying to do is help your turtles get to the top. So we want to help the college counselors get their students into the best schools as painlessly as possible. So it's one place where you can easily track your deadlines, your documents, and your students' application progress. So students are able to know what they need to get done and when. And like I said, instead of having your documents in your email, instead of having Excel files with your student information, instead of having WeChat messages, exchanging revisions, assignments back and forth, you can go to one place, Turtle Camp, instead of being all over the place. So we're going to go through a demo of the product, and you'll get to see how we've tried to use data visualizations, use task management, and try and simplify the process so you always know what your students are working on, and your students always know what they need to do and what they need to get done so that they can get into the best schools as possible. And Johnny's gonna walk us through that process.
Okay, hi guys. So I'm Johnny. I'm going to be your educational consultant or counselor today, and I'm gonna get you into your dream school. Let's log in. So, as a counselor, when I log in, when I remember my password, all right. So when I log in, what I see is a list of all my students. So these are all of the students that I'm helping. I'm helping them on their essays and compile all their documents and do all the things that they need to do for their college applications one by one. So first thing I see when I log in is all my students. I notice Mark Tsai, he has 5 tasks pending my approval. So this task pending approval is things that I need to check off and say, okay, that's good. That's good for your application. You can send it off. All right, so let's see what he's been up to. Whoa, okay. Looks like Mark finished his Columbia University application. Go, Mark, go. So, all right. Kind of a quick overview of what's happening on the page here. It's a lot. But we were inspired kind of by project management web apps, so such as like Trello or Basecamp. That's kind of where the camp and Turtle Camp came from, to be honest. We wanted not just a place to store your documents, but we also wanted something that can tell the student and the counselor what they need to be doing. It's nice to have a to-do list, but it would also be nice if you could have something more comprehensive that lays out in the coming weeks and months what you need to do, and in the short term, what you need to do. So this is the counselor view still, by the way. So up in the right-hand corner, I see Mark's quick info, just all of his test scores and at school, et cetera. And then below that, next task. That's the next thing that Mark needs to get done. And down on the bottom two rows there, we have a timeline which shows for all 3 of his applications that he's working on right now, the how many tasks I have assigned to him, what days they're due on, so that Mark can kind of visualize his workload. And then on the right is a breakdown of tasks that he's finished and not finished and that are pending my approval. So as I mentioned, there's 5 tasks that are pending my approval from Mark. So if I click on Massachusetts Institute of Technology, there's 3 pending tasks. And here we have all of the tasks that I've assigned Mark. And it's kind of a more specific, school-specific breakdown of his upcoming tasks for his MIT application. And then down here is like a more traditional kind of to-do list. But Mark, I assigned these tasks to him. And then when he sees them, he has to go and do them. For example, finish personal statement letter. That's a task that I assigned to him. And I can see over here that there's an attachment, and it's pending. So that means that Mark has uploaded an attachment. I can download it. I can review the document. All right, did you download it?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, good. Check it out. Yeah, we check it out. All right. Or not, it's okay, it's an empty thing. But I guess that, I can mark that as approval. Yeah, approved, good job, Mark. Yeah, okay, yeah. Now, let's go back to my students page. Yeah, I go back to, or you go back to Mark's page. You can see that he's made progress. I guess it's okay. All right, now this is Mark's view. This is what Mark sees. He sees my face. And he also sees his next upcoming task and his progress on his individual applications. Mark can add a school, and he can mark, he can see. Okay, now he's up to 42%. Completion on his MIT application, scrolls down. He sees that his personal statement has been approved, and now Mark can put that in his application. It's good to go. You want to go back to the counselor view? And counselors can add students as many as they want for now. And sure, yeah. So we can add a student, Sophia, email Sophia, yeah. One thing that we implemented is we wanted to keep things away from email. We use an email for login, but we wanted to kind of have this be complementary to the offline experience of college counseling as well. So this would be the password, a temporary password that is given. The counselor would then take this, give it to their student. All right, time. Wait, one thing that we wanted to say is kind of where this was going to go, and we really would like to get parents more involved in this flow, and
Yeah, so like I said, it was really difficult to develop this in 2 weeks from idea to what you've seen today. So we initially started off with a lot more in mind. We wanted to make a way for parents to join in on the process and collaborate so they can see what their students are working on and also, you know, sign off on documents. Because parents are paying a lot of money to the consultants to get their students into the top schools. We also wanted to better integrate college information about colleges so that when you add a school, you can go ahead and see the deadlines, you can see the essays that need to be done, and you don't have to go to another website. So right now, this is just the start of what we think is a much better college application project management software that students, counselors, and parents can use to help simplify the process and really focus on what really matters, getting into their future, into the best schools.
Woo. Well done, Dr. Khan. A few questions from anyone here. Any questions you want to ask?
Oh yeah, in the back.
In the back first, apparently.
Yeah.
Business model?
So right now this would be a subscription for college counselors. So that's how we've thought about it, is that private college counselors would go ahead and purchase a certain number of students, student accounts that they could then use. So whether you're an individual college consultant or whether you're part of a larger company that needs to purchase software for your counselors, that would be the way for now that we've envisioned this. Yeah, the students, it would be free for them. Their counselors would be purchasing the software.
What was the most technically difficult thing about making the website?
Honestly, I think that technically difficult You want to talk about like managing people and everybody being on the same page. That's technically difficult. Yeah. learning to collaborate on software is a tech skill in and of its own, I think. So everybody, it's like, oh, you just made the landing page? I just made a landing page. Like, stuff like that kind of happens. And I think that sometimes that learning to work on a team is just as difficult as developing the software itself. Yeah. But technically, I don't know. It was all pretty hard. Yeah. For a beginner, you know.
One more question.
Versioning software? Yeah, we've thought about that. Yeah, but
they are using GitHub.
Oh yeah, yes, yeah, we use GitHub. Yeah.
I was just wondering, because I've seen you guys come all the way from the beginning to here, and yeah, I'm really impressed by what you guys are able to do at the end. What advice would you give to someone who's thinking about doing something similar, starting from nothing, and then being able to create like something like that in about 9 weeks?
I don't know, just don't do it by yourself. That's my answer.
Find good mentors, find good teachers, people that are willing to teach you, and good team, yeah. Stefan right here, he doesn't want to talk, but he started from nothing, I'll speak for him. And I think a lot of, everyone in this batch has really, we really don't have a background, so like, it's really amazing. 9 weeks, and in 2 weeks,
just be willing to work hard. You're gonna be up very, very late if you wanna do this in 0 to 9 weeks later, build something like this. So just be willing to work hard, be willing to learn, and be willing to collaborate with your teachers and your peers, and you'll be good.
No, none of us had technical background before this.
Woohoo! Well done! Well done, Dr. Kemp!
Thank you!
Now we have the last product, the last team here. This is a White Days, as you can see right now. It's about a wedding, okay? This is Mark from the US, this is Sebastian from Argentina, this is Jing from China. We have 10 minutes, let's go.
Thanks, Thibaut. Like Thibaut said, this is Jing from China, who works here in Shanghai. She's the head of design at Hey Shop, and is it on? Testing. Okay. She's the head of design at Hey Shop, and she's the mastermind behind our design and templates. This is Sebastian from Argentina, who has a background in marketing and has become a very good developer very quickly. And I'm Mark from the US with the background in marketing. So before we get started, I'll let you know there's a little bit of audience participation. So have your cell phones ready near the end. I'm going to want you all to do something, but you'll see. So first, let's start with a question. Who here is married or is about to get married soon? Okay. Now keep your hands up if you really, really enjoyed the process of going through your list of people to invite, sending out invitations, and you know, doing that whole thing. Does anybody really, really enjoy that? No? Okay. One, two. Well, if you enjoyed that, then this project might not be for you. So this is Wedtails. The idea is, in China, you might have a large extended network that you want to send invitations to, that you could send, you know, paper invitations, but it might be a little bit rude and a little bit forward to send paper invitations to everybody you haven't spoken to in a long time. The idea here is you create a digital invitation that you can share on WeChat. You can tell the story of your wedding. Tell the story to your extended network of who you are and about your fiance for the people that might not have spoken to you in a long time. So this is our landing page. We have one of our templates up here in front. And if we go down to features, you can see some of the core features of our product. We want to inspire your friends to come. We want to create a beautiful wedding invitation. Of course, you're going to share that wedding invitation. And our last feature would be the RSVP feature. We want to know who's actually coming to your wedding. If we go down to invitations, we can see some of our sample invitations up front where people can get inspired to build their own story. So if we go through the process, we can start with the login. Here we've added an email login. We've also added Facebook sign up and WeChat sign up. So as soon as we log in with the Wagon and get our password down, we can go to the next step, which will be the dashboard. Password reminder might be useful here as well. Okay, and then from here, we can go to the dashboard. Now, this is where we see all of the invitations we've created. So let's say I want one, and then my fiance wants one that might be different style, or however you want to do it. So let's go to create invitation. Here is where you select your invitation. We have two free ones right now, and then we're going to have premium invitations where you can pay a subscription fee or a small fee to use our premium invitations. So let's start with the Tiffany Blue. And this is where you're going to want to tell your story. We've designed the user experience to maybe take like one or two minutes, but then, you know, Seb might take a little bit longer. We're going to put in a location so the user can get a map, share where your wedding is, and then you tell the story of your wedding. While Seb is doing that, I want to talk about one other feature that we're thinking about adding in the future, which would be to create a management platform for agencies. So if you think about it, there's a lot of agencies in China that manage a bunch of different weddings. With our platform, we can expand it so that you can not just manage your own wedding, but you can manage a whole bunch of other weddings. And the last feature here is the RSVP. This is so when you send out a digital invitation, you can get back all the information for the people that want to go to your wedding. So if we go next, we can move on to our share feature. Now, on the share feature, which will be coming up in a minute, is where we can customize the URL and build the features that you can share on WeChat, so on and so forth, with like little icons to share. And sorry, the server's a little bit slow. Okay, so we're going to skip forward where you can choose the share information here. And you create your description and your custom URL. This is where you see your invitation. On the left side, you can see a preview invitation. And if you scan that QR code, you can go ahead and get invited to our wedding. So if everybody would just take a quick scan of that. And once you see the invitation on your phone, you can scroll all the way down to the bottom where there's an RSVP feature where you can actually go ahead and accept our invitation to our wedding. So you can see a little bit more of our... All right, I think everybody's got it. So if you take a quick look here, this is Seb, if you want to show on the rest of the invitation. This will be like your customized template with your pictures, with some nice animations, and a story. Yeah. So if we go back to the dashboard, you can see all of your invitations. And we have some features here. So you can edit. And then, of course, you can see your invitation. And then we get a share link with that. And then, of course, we have the guest list. So if we go to our guest list, we can see who has responded to our wedding. We have a couple of people, Michael John and Thibault, who have agreed to come to our wedding. All right, so the idea behind our project is, you know, engaging in the wedding market. So in China, there's tens of millions of weddings every single year. And the idea is we want to make that process a little bit easier.
Well done, well done.
A lot of guests in this wedding, coming. Questions, please.
How do you divide the tasks? Who is going to be responsible for it?
Well, it was actually, that's kind of challenging because we're the smallest team and we, you know, really want to experience a little bit of everything. We all started from zero coding background. Jing has a lot of experience in design, so she was naturally our designer. But she also wants to do some backend. So literally, it was task by task. You'll make this controller, I'll make this form, you'll do this front end. Kind of how we did it. So we tried not to specialize as much as possible so that we get experience a little bit of everything.
Actually, the idea came to me is because I see some friend, they send me their invitation, digital invitations, but one of my friend, she sent me two. Actually, she made two invitations, and she couldn't choose which one to use. So he sent me two. So I think it just came to me, what if I made the design for the invitation, so I made the invitation like this. Yeah.
It's kind of up to you. The idea is, you, like, let's say you have your core group that you definitely want to come, you probably would send a paper invitation to as well. But the idea about this is you can share it with everybody. So like, let's say you just want to put it on WeChat and you don't want to get a response, then you don't have to put the RSVP feature, then you can just share the information about your wedding with pictures and stuff like that. If you want it to be an actual invitation, then you can pick and choose who you want to send it to. Yeah. Anyone else? Okay.
I've been looking a lot at like WeChat meeting programs, I think. I think this could be like a really cool case for a WeChat meeting program where something is at least a year being ongoing. Have you kind of explored that idea? I don't know, you're the education.
Yeah, we did all this in 2 weeks. We have explored that a little bit. So like right now we have WeChat login, which actually only works on WeChat itself. And then we are going to add other WeChat features like the WeChat menu bar and stuff like that. So, and even the templates themselves are designed for the WeChat screen on an iPhone. So yeah, it is very much focused towards WeChat.
All right, very well done. Very well done, thank you. Thank you, thank you very much. Thank you very much all. Thank you especially to the students here. You guys have done an amazing work. We are all very proud of you. Amazing. Honestly, what they've done, great. Thank you so much. I have a final word for you guys. I have to explain to you that this is an amazing community and you have to stay connected with this community. You know how intense they are everywhere around the world. Now it's just the beginning of this journey. You have to learn so much new things. Please, obviously, stay connected with all these people. Now, a word for you guys, if there are recruiters here in this room, you would be idiots not to recruit them. Actually, some of them already have landed a job, but a few of them are still looking for opportunities, so come to me, and eventually I will tell you who is for sale. Thank you. Thank you so much, all of you. Please come here on the stage with me. We can have a little group. Please, here, all of you, come here to have a little picture. I want to thank, first of all, the teachers, the mentors. They have been badass. They have been very, very patient to make it happen. Without them, these guys would have had a lot of nightmares. They've been amazingly helpful. So thank you, Forrest. Thank you, Michael John. Thank you. Please join us. Eric, that was very, very helpful. That was Gabby. That was Dimitri. We are 9 different instructors. So thank you so much for making it happen. Thank you for all the companies also. There are so many companies that welcome them to visit and understand how it worked, what's going in there. So strikingly, IT consultants, Kawo, it was really awesome to go there and meet them. So thank you for these companies. Thank you for Xnode having us in this place. Amazing co-working space. Really awesome. Thank you so much, Wei, for this. Well, now,
we are moving forward to the last part, drinks. Of course, it's social time. Please meet with all of these guys and have an awesome evening. Thank you for being here tonight.
And first and last but not least, I think we have to say thank you to Thibaut to making the Wagon China a reality. So he's been working on the Wagon for the last 8 months or so to bring a boot camp like this to China, and it's not easy. I've seen him work really hard to spread the word, to throw events every week and get people involved and really build a community here. So thanks everybody for coming, and thank you so much, Thibaut, for this.